Hello friends and welcome to this video. My name is Devvrati Patil and in this video we are going to develop the MATLAB program for Newton's forward interpolation method. So let's open the MATLAB window. MATLAB interface, I have already opened the editor window where we want to write the MATLAB program for the Newton forward interpolation method. Now let's start with the comment. So giving the comment use the percentage symbol and then write the name of the method, that is Newton forward interpolation. And now next we have to write the three magical words for the MATLAB, that is CLC, clear all and close all, which clears all your command window and all the workspaces, and also if any window is open previously, figure window, then it will be closed. After that, we have to start writing the program. Now for this, it will be written as per the given problem statement. So first we have given the number of data points and the HG value. As we already prepared the flowchart in the previous video, if you not watch that video, please watch where the detailed flowchart is explained. So using that flowchart we are going to develop the MATLAB program. So let's see the flowchart again. This is the flowchart and the problem statement. The flowchart is already explained in the previous video. The problem statement is given. We are using the same problem statement which numerical we have already shown in the previous video. That value we have to consider. So here at the start we have to input the given data, that is n and the xg value, that is the value at which we have to require to calculate the value of y. Then we have to input all the data points of x and y variables. So this is required for loop and it will be starting from 1 to n because MATLAB array does not recognize the x of 0 value. So it will be starting from 1. So we have to input the first value as a x of 1, y of 1, likewise. So you have to input the x of y values and y of I comma 1 values. Why I comma 1? It is already explained in the previous video. So you have to watch that video so you can get sure. So why it will be written as a y of I comma 1. So after that, then you have to calculate the h value, u value, and after that prepare the forward difference statement. So let's start to write the MATLAB program. So the first line will be the given data, that is first is the n as a number of data points are given, and then second will be the xg value. We have to take the input of xg value, that is the value of x at which we require to calculate the value of y. So xg will be written as the input, and then next we have to take the input of all x values and all y values. So for this we have to use the for loop I is equal to 1 to n. Writing the loop for I is equal to 1 to n and then taking the x values and y values as the input in the same fashion as we done in the previous video for the Lagrange's interpolation method. So first we have to take the x values as the input. So it will be written f printf and x of I as the input values. After that, same fashion for this y values, so just copying and pasting it in. And replacing the x with y. And then we have to end this loop. So it will be taken all the values of x and y values. And here it must be, remember that here y value is the two-way array value. So we have to write as a I comma 1 and not just as a I. So here written as I comma 1. Why I comma 1 is it already explained. So then we have to end this loop. And then next we have to calculate the value of h and then value of u. So h will be written as x of 2 minus x of 1 value because the initial value is x of 1. And then we have to calculate the value of u, which is xg minus x of 1 and divided by h. And don't forget to use the appropriate brackets of calculating the value of u, because MATLAB is a case sensitive as well as it follows all the mathematical rules. And now next we have to prepare the forward difference table. So we have to use the for loop starting from j also, and one is for I also. So as per this flowchart. Now as per this flowchart, as we have to calculate the forward differences value, so we have to start from j is equal to 2n, because we have to calculate, consider the values from y. So j will be started from 2, and then for loop for I, which is starting from 1 to n minus j plus 1, and then calculating this forward difference table. So this is the forward difference table we have to calculate, and in MATLAB also we have to write in the same fashion. So write in the loop for j is equal to 2 to n, and then the next loop for I is equal to 1 to n minus j plus 1. It will be written in terms of j value, because when we calculate the difference vertically, then the last value we can't get. So each column we get the one value short. So that's why it will be written in terms of j and plus 1 value. After that we have to calculate this forward difference in terms of y of I comma j. So y of I comma j will be written as y of I comma j is equal to the next value minus the current value. So in terms of I and j it will be written. So it will be y of I comma j is equal to y of I plus 1 comma j minus 1 minus y of I comma j minus 1. So at the start our I is 1, so inner loop will be started first. So y of 1 comma j is 2, so 1 comma 2 is equal to y of I plus 1. 1 plus 1 is 2 minus j minus 1. 2 minus 1, 1. So we will be get 2 comma 1 value minus y of I comma j minus 1. So 1 comma 1 value. So in this way we have to calculate all the forward differences when I will be getting increment, and after that completing the loop j will be getting the increment. So we have to end the loop for both I first and then j by writing the end. After that we have to initialize the value of yg and u1. As per the flowchart, we have to consider this yg value as a initialize y of 1 and u1 will be 1, because in the yg formula this first value is appear only once. So that's why we have initialized this y of 1, and this u1 will be considered as a 1, because this u term will be considered as a u1, and there is a simultaneous multiplication of values. So that's why it will be initialized as a 1. When simultaneous multiplication is there, we are initialized as a 1 value. After that we have to calculate the yg value, and where only j will be getting the increment, because we have to consider only this first row where 1, that is I is equal to 1, is constant and j is only going to be changed. So that's why only one loop will be considered, that is for j is equal to 1 to n minus 1. So initialize the value of yg as a y of 1 value, and the value of u1 will be a 1 value. Now next we have to use this for loop for j is equal to 1 to n minus 1, because there is only increment in the j variable. We will require only first row value. And after that we have to calculate the first u1 value, that is a factorial term. It will be written as u1 is equal to u1 into u minus j plus 1 divided by j. So when there is j is equal to 1, the u1 value will be considered as the first 1 value, and into u, you already calculate above, so you will be calculated as xj minus x1 divided by h. So that value will be considered here, then minus j plus 1. And it will be written as yg is equal to again right hand side term same variable, that is yg plus u1, that is this value, into y of 1 comma j plus, that is the delta y value. So initial value is a delta y1, then delta square y1 and delta square y2. So first initial value is 1 is constant, so 1 comma j plus 1, j is the first value in the difference table, that is this value, and this value is nothing but 1 comma 2 value. So that's why it will be represented here, and as you can observe here in yg formula, here is a u into delta y. So this value will be assigned to the u1 variable, this value total will be assigned to the u1 variable again. So when j will becomes 2, then it will be calculated as the u values, that is the u1 values is equal to u1. So first assigned term is u, that is it will be assigned that into, so when j is equal to 2, then u1 value is u will be assigned to u1, and you will be get u into u minus j plus 1. So u value is again minus j plus 1, that is 2 plus 1 and then divided by 2. So you will be get as a 2 factorial. So in this way we can calculate all the u1 values and then we will be get the ug value. So after writing this value, we have to end this loop and then print the value of yg. To print the value of yg, we have to write the fprintf syntax, and in bracket we have to return the value of yg is equal to %f at xg is equal to %f. So at first %f, it prints the value of yg, and second %f, it prints the value of xg. Now save this program and run this program to get the answers. In run the program, the message will be appear in the command window. It asks you to enter the number of data points. So to input the values, we have considered the same numerical we have solved in the previous video lecture. So taking that values, the numerical is, this is the numerical where x values and y values are given. So 1, 2, 3 and 4. End data is 4, xg value is 1.5, and we have to input all these values of x and y respectively. So let's input n value as a 4, xg value as a 1.5, and then different values of x and y. So x values are 0 to 46 and y values are 529, 125 and 341. So these values we have to enter. First value of x is 0, y value is 5, then second value is 2 and 29, 4 and 125, 6 and 341. And we will be get the answer as yg is equal to 18.125. So it is the same answer as we get while solving the numerical. Now next we have to write the MATLAB solver syntax. To validate the answer, we have to use the MATLAB solver syntax. For this purpose, we have to define the value of x, which is equal to in square bracket 0, 2, 4, 6, do semicolon, then value of y, which are 5, 29, 125 and 341. Do the semicolon and then define the value of xg, because these values are required in the MATLAB solver syntax. Xg value is 1.5. Do semicolon, enter. Then we have to write the MATLAB solver syntax, yg is the variable. Enter p1 the MATLAB solver syntax for the interpolation, bracket x comma y value comma xg value, at which we require to calculate the value of yg. Then give again comma, use inverted quote, then write the spline. Spline is the method to print the data points. So after giving spline and then give that, don't give the semicolon after this MATLAB syntax. Then we will be get the value as 18.125, which is same as we calculated and getting by the program value. So we can observe here this value is same, so our answer is correct. So in this way you can develop the MATLAB program for this Newton's interpolation method. Thank you for watching this video.